You guys, what's up? My name is Sarah. Welcome back to my channel. I have quite the urban legend to share with you guys tonight. So just sit back, relax, get comfortable, and imagine being chased down a dark road at night, all alone in the middle of the woods. What is the scariest thing that could be chasing you? Is it something like a wild animal, like a wolf or a mountain lion? Or is it something more like an axe murderer? Okay, so I know you read the title of the video, but if you hadn't, you probably wouldn't have thought of a ghost of a three-legged lady. But you have to admit that she definitely deserves a place of honor on the list of scariest things to chase you down a dark road. But still, plenty of people seek her out and dare her to do just that. So, Three-Legged Lady Road is more officially called Nash Road, and it's a long winding stretch of dirt road through the thick southern woods of Mississippi near Columbus. You might want to say that the road isn't really that creepy by daylight, but there still is something chilling about it. Maybe it's the cemetery, or maybe it's the ruins of the old church, or it could just be the road itself. Nash Road is narrow and can easily turn dangerous, even in the best of conditions, if you happen to meet another car out there. At other times, in the dark, or during storms, or when the road floods after it rains, there is plenty of opportunity for accidents to happen. Even more so when teens trying to race the ghosts of a three-legged lady take one of those sharp turns in the middle of the night. There are a few different versions of not only the story behind the legend, but also this actual ritual to summon the three-legged lady to a race. Some versions say that you need to knock on the church door 3 times to summon her, but since the church has been torn down, or if you believe some versions of the legend burned down, it doesn't seem like knocking on the door 3 times is possible anymore. These days, some people say that you need to flash your headlights 3 times, but the most common version of the legend says that you need to honk your horn 3 times. This group of ghost hunters tried to summon the three-legged lady for a spirit box session, and I'll play you a little bit of what they picked up. So I'm a little bit skeptical there. I didn't really hear anything myself. I know they heard someone saying, "Help me." I didn't think I heard that very clearly, but if you did, make sure you leave a comment letting me know that you did, or if you heard anything else. And make sure you check out their channel and check out the video and let them know that you heard stuff too. Well, normally, according to the legend, after you knock on the door or flash your lights or honk your horn 3 times, the ghost of the three-legged lady will appear from the woods, hop on the roof of your car, and knock 3 times. What happens next, though, is similar, but up for interpretation. All can agree that she'll run alongside your car down the road. Some people say that she just chases you, and you can't look back until you reach a turn in the road by the gate, or else she'll open that gate, you'll drive out into the empty field, and there she'll kill you. Most versions of the story, however, say that she races you down the road. Some say it's to that same gate, others say it's to a bridge that features in some versions of the backstory. Either way, she said to throw herself against your car the entire way, trying to run you off that narrow dirt road. And some people even say that they found dents in their car after a frantic race with a three-legged lady. Some others have found handprints on their car afterward, and still others, while not finding any tangible evidence, did hear a woman's whispers following them all the way driving down the road. There are stories online of people who didn't even know the road was haunted, but who could still sense that something was wrong on just their innocent drive-through, not even realizing the full horror of the location until they looked it up online later. And now, while I share some of the backstory, let's look at some footage from those same ghost hunters driving down that dark road at night after they had summoned the three-legged lady, just so you can get a feel for what the road looks like And then also maybe we can catch some orbs or weird shadows or something. So let's check it out. Here we go. I'll put it up here. Now, whether you think she chases you or races you down the road, and why she does so depends on what backstory you hear. And there are a few different versions of this, but all equally horrifying in different ways. So a couple versions say that the three-legged lady is a wife. In one, she had an affair with a young Civil War veteran, and her husband, a poor, honest farmer, caught them and killed her lover. He then dragged the lover's body down the road and over the bridge, but when the lover's leg got caught on the bridge boards, it tore off. The man's funeral was held at the church nearby on the road. The woman, however, went mad from the loss of her lover. She ended up finding his leg on the bridge and she sewed it onto her own body. She then killed herself and killed her husband, and now she haunts the church where she had last seen her lover at his funeral. And according to this version of the legend, you summon her by knocking on that church door 3 times and you race her to that bridge. A second version, a variation of the first, is that the wife is very devoted to her husband. So devoted that when she caught him having the affair, and after she had killed and dismembered him in her madness, she secretly sewed one of his legs onto her own body so that she could keep him with her forever, hidden under her skirts. Now, someone from the church found out about this, and they threatened to turn her in for murder if she didn't confess first. So, desperate to keep her secret, she went to the church on Sunday during Mass. But instead of going inside, she locked the door and set the church on fire. The place went up in flames. Some of the congregation managed to escape, but they were so badly burned that they died running through the woods, their bodies remaining scattered and lost to the forest. The three-legged lady was never seen again, at least alive. Today they say her spirit haunts the grounds of the church and that she tries to kill anyone who threatens to tell her secret. In this version, the church is actually burned down, so there's no special objective to erase. It's just a run for your life situation after she attempts to hunt you down once you have crossed the church grounds. Another couple of versions identify the three-legged lady as a mother. For our third story, the woman's daughter was kidnapped, dismembered, and her limbs were strewn throughout the woods alongside Nash Road. The single leg is all the distraught mother was able to find, but her spirit still searches for the remains of her daughter in the woods today. Some say that she simply drags a leg alongside her, but others say that she attached it to her own body either to protect it or just to keep her daughter close. Our fourth story is a version of this with the same general ending, but the daughter wasn't kidnapped by a random killer. Instead, she was captured by a satanic cult that took up residence in the church after it was abandoned and they were performing dark rituals there. It was as a part of one of these rituals that the daughter was sacrificed, dismembered, and scattered throughout the woods. Again, the mother still searches for her daughter's limbs, having found only the leg. A fifth version of the legend also focuses on this satanic cult, the church. But in this version, the three-legged lady herself was summoned or created somehow by a ritual that this cult had performed. This version doesn't really say that she's a demon, but some people online pointed out that they knew a story from back in the 60s of a six-legged woman who was simply a demonic entity who chased people down the Mississippi backroads just a couple dozen miles away from Nash Road. So perhaps a three-legged woman is a version of the same demonic entity, but just a three-legged one summoned by that cult at that church. Our last few versions of the story feel much more real, and in some ways, they also kind of feel more upsetting for that reason. For our sixth version of the story, the three-legged lady was actually just a girl who was hit and killed by a car while having a three-legged race with her brother down the road. And presumably the third leg is actually that of her brother, and it also does explain why she would be racing drivers down the road. The seventh version is also about a girl, but this is a girl who was born with a condition where some of her organs were outside of her body. The doctor tied her organs up together and they hung down her body, almost appearing like a third leg. And everyone made fun of her for this. They called her a three-legged girl. And eventually she just couldn't take it anymore and she snapped. When everyone was at church, she locked the doors and burned the church down, much like in the other version of the story that we talked about. The deceased were buried in the nearby cemetery along the road. The girl grew up, but eventually, after a prolonged hospital stay, she also did die from her condition. She was buried in that same cemetery as well, and so that's where her spirit haunts today, claiming the graves of her tormentors still. Some also say that she not only chases people away from the graves that she's guarding, but that she also has a particular vendetta against any descendants of those people who had tormented her and who are buried there. Our last story simply says that there was just a lesbian woman who was treated as a pariah by her conservative southern town, and so she lived alone in the woods there a few decades ago. She didn't have three legs or anything like that at all. People were just making up scary stories about her just to bully her and to be mean. It's nothing as dramatic and supernatural as our first few stories were, but certainly such bullying is a very real thing, and that kind of makes this version just as unsettling. All right, so now on to the specific evidence. Did you guys see anything in that video? I don't really think that I did. It's definitely creepy. And did you notice the gate? I'll play it again here. Yeah, so there was that bit of the gate, which is near that turn in the road. It definitely does all seem creepy, right? Just how narrow the road is. But I didn't see anything. But if you did, again, be sure to mention it down in the comments. Let me know what you saw. And also go check out the original video and leave comments there letting them know if you saw stuff, because I'm sure they'd definitely be interested in hearing what you noticed. So I did find a few firsthand accounts online of weird things that have happened on this road. None of them involve the three-legged lady, weirdly enough, but maybe we can read them and find some connection or learn at least a little bit more about whatever haunting is happening here. So here is the first one. They said, "My daughter, son-in-law, and I used to live near here, close to the base actually. Anyway, we'd heard about the three-legged lady and all, but my son-in-law had to go see for himself. Well, we talked about it for a minute and finally went down to the three-legged lady road. So he's driving slowly and decided to stop. My daughter was like, 'Oh no, you don't,' but he did anyway. So he got out and looked around outside the car. Then we noticed there was a man standing about 1,500 feet in front of the car. He was dirty and wearing overalls. He was holding a small boy's hand on one side and had an axe in his other hand. My daughter started freaking out. I finally got out of the back seat and looked. The man was missing his legs and was see-through. The little boy had blood on his head and was visible only to the torso. Needless to say, we all got in the car and turned around as fast as possible and took off. And we have never been back." So it is strange that they didn't have any legs. That could kind of be a connection, right, to the three-legged lady. Weird though, she has an extra leg and they have fewer. Maybe they're the spirit of some of the other ghosts involved. Maybe it's their legs that she took that they're missing. Maybe there's some more to the story or other versions that we haven't heard. That could be interesting. Not sure who these characters are though, this man and this boy. Not sure why the man was holding an axe, why the boy had blood on his head. All very weird, disturbing things. One thing that does cause me to question this account is just that number there. 1,500 feet is quite a ways away, actually. Maybe that was a mistake and a typo. Maybe it wasn't 1,500 feet away, but that's like, what, a couple football fields? Not sure that they necessarily would have seen very clearly, even if they actually noticed them that far away. So that's just something to kind of question a little bit. But otherwise, still a good story. I like that one. Okay, so here's another one from someone who says that they've experienced some weird things. Again, I'll put it up here. And they say, "Yeah, I live out there. There isn't a bridge though. And if you go to the spot where the church burned down and go to the concrete slab and stand there while your buddy honks the horn, she will pop up and chase you to the first curve. Just don't take any wrong turns. The people down there aren't very friendly. We went and an old man shot at my truck. But it does work. We have done it. And we saw something. It was like a dark shadow. Then it turned into this weird mist type of thing and flew at our car. We had handprints on the side, and none of us ever touched my truck." Okay, so it's interesting that they mention that there isn't a bridge. I haven't really seen a lot of people question the bridge part of the legend, so maybe there is a bridge a little bit farther down, or maybe just in a different direction or something like that. And this story is interesting. I wouldn't normally think much about like a dark shadow. Dark shadow alone, there are a lot of shadows in the woods, not that exciting. But a mist is pretty interesting. And the handprints, they could have been there before, but I'm not really sure about the mist. That's what kind of gets me from this story. But what do you guys think? Can you debunk it? Do you think the mist was maybe just passing fog or something like that? What is that something that, I don't know. I'm not really sure. I can't kind of picture that, a little pocket of fog. But let me know down in the comments what you guys think about that, because I'm not really sure. But in general, I just think that the Three-Legged Lady of Nash Road is a really rich urban legend. And there are just so many twists and turns to the backstory and to the ritual itself. And haunted roads and the rituals that go with them are actually some of my favorite hauntings. So if you enjoyed this video and found this creepy story just as interesting as I did, make sure you leave a like so that I know that you like these types of stories. And don't forget to check out my content elsewhere online for just smaller versions rather than a compilation like this. Also on TikTok and Instagram at Sarah Mast, you can find some more stuff there. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel right here on YouTube. Just hit the little subscribe button down there if you haven't already. I'm posting extra videos throughout October for spooky season, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of that. But I also am posting videos regularly now on Tuesdays, Fridays, and Sundays, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of those. I've already planned out a bunch of the videos and they are some really spooky stories, so you don't want to miss it, trust me. Our next video is going to be up on Sunday, so until then, guys, peace.